guys, RMP Connect here. Just doing the next video for showing the inside and everything up and working. I'll kind of go over everything. I'll start over here, I guess. On the side here, these are the two hard drive bays. It's got two 120mm fans blowing across. As you can see right there, there's one of the hard drives. That is the Western Digital Caviar Black 750 gig. Then you have another down here which holds another four drives, but I don't have anything in there, so the fans are just on, just blowing air across. I was planning on trying to move them to maybe mount this bottom one to the side panel, but I don't know, we'll see what happens. As you can see, these are red LEDs. if you go to the top here, on the very top here, you have the different controls. And if you push the center button here, it shuts off the lights, turns back on. It does get a little beep. Same thing with the setting the controls to make them faster and slower, things like that. They beep and gives you two settings per notch, I guess you could say. And then, like I said, the very top here, the bigger button, gives you the CoolerMaster logo. And I've shown this in the review. So go back to the side here. Okay, so here is the Enermax 1020 watt power supply mounted on the bottom. The fan is facing down, so it's sucking the air from underneath and blowing it out the back. And it has like a real nice finish to it. It has like a kind of like a twinkly metallic look to it. Gives a real nice look. It's got the Revolution and 85 plus on the side, which is kind of cool. And most of it is modular. Inside here, there we go. So you can see that it's fairly modular. There's a couple of things, like, but I went over the review and stuff like that, so I only had to plug in a couple of things. It's not too bad. Down on the bottom there are my SSD drives. One is for storage and one is for games. The top one here is an OCZ 60 gig. The bottom one here is an Intel 120 gig for all my games and things, for Steam games and whatever. And then the other drive, mechanical drive, it has all my storage files and backup saves and whatnot. So, okay. So, okay. Now, what you can see here is there's only two 580s. I did get the third one, and as you saw in the video, I had the third one. When I put it in the system, it was defective. I was getting constant crashes, artifacting like crazy. When I took it out, everything ran fine. I put it back in, artifacting like crazy. So I tried it by itself, same thing, all sorts of artifacts. Drivers were crashing, I couldn't even run any games. The second I turn on a game, bam, it was done. So, I'm not sure when the benchmarks are. I have to send it back out. And hopefully we'll see, you know, hopefully when I get another one, it might be, I think it takes about a week to get there, and another week to come back, so it'll be a couple of weeks before I see the third one again. If I decide to even keep it, I'm not even sure. I mean, it's another $600 that, I mean, it's hard to justify. I mean, yeah, it's really cool. I have pictures of it inside the system, and I'll put the videos, the pictures on the, at the end of this video. It was really cool, and it made the case look real sexy having all three of them in there. But like I said, I don't know if I really want to keep it yet. But we'll see what happens. Okay, so so this is the two 580s. Everything's nice and neat, tucked away. The cable management was excellent in this case, absolutely awesome. And then in the middle there, I still have my Sound Blaster X5 Fatality Edition that I've had for probably about 5 years. So that's the best $150 sound card I've ever bought. Actually, it's the most expensive video sound card I've ever bought anyway. But it's lasted me 5 years for that sound card, and it's incredible. So so this is the two-way SLI bridge. And then, move up a little bit here. As you can see, the cable management is just excellent. The 24-pin, you know, tucks away real nice. It was kind of hard to get it in there because of how wide the motherboard is, that the grommet here stops about midway through the 24 pin when it connects, so I had to kind of really finagle the wires in and to get it to connect over. It was kind of a pain, but it in the long run it works out and it looks really good. And I have all my SATA connectors in the back there. Then you have my Corsair Vengeance 1600 RAM, and then the Corsair H100 cooler, of course. And you have the buttons here. So now I'm on the lowest speed, and you press it again, goes up to the middle, and then to the fastest. So that's pretty cool. You do have the 140mm fan in the back. You have the three rubber grommets up top, like I showed in the case. This motherboard does have the two 8-pin motherboard connectors. I'm only using one because I'm not overclocking this thing to, you know, astronomical numbers, so I don't really need it. And then on the top is the radiator mounted with fans. Now, I want you guys to note that there is not enough room to do a push-pull configuration with this case. You can put single fans on, but that's about it. If you go to the top of the case, you can add one more fan underneath here, but you cannot add the second one over this fan here because the carrying the handle where it straps and actually mounts to the actual chassis itself gets in the way. So you can put one extra additional fan on this side with plenty of clearance and you won't have any issues. So on the back side, or on the back side of the hard drive cages, there's really not much to tell. It's nice and clean. And on the top there is the Asus 24-speed DVD burner. So yeah, man, this case is just, it's remarkable. It keeps everything nice and clean, and as you can see, it's very well hidden, all the cables and everything like that. It does get a little tight in the back, but there is enough room where you shouldn't have any problems at all. Okay, so we'll go over to the front here. So in the front, we've seen the top. I showed you all that stuff. And then as you come down, you got the X dock station for the SSD. I have my Asus DVD burner. And then you have this EVGA ECP control panel, which gives you three buttons here. Two for VCore and one for the VCCSA, which I believe is the EVGA's way of saying the PLL or the QPI voltage. Now basically what happens when you press one of these buttons, if you press the first one, it ups your core voltage by 0.1. So if you were at, say, 1.3 volts and you press that, you would jump to 1.4. Then you can press the second button, which increases it by another 0.1, so then you'd be at 1.5 volts, so on and so forth. And then the same thing with the VCCSA goes up by 0.1 volts. And then down below you have the option to disable the PCI Express disable. You can shut off the different lanes if you don't want to use it. And you have the clear CMOS button. And then you have the post code and CPU temperature, which it sits a little bit higher than what the core temp actually reads, but it's within 2 to 3 degrees higher, so it's nothing to worry about. This is probably more accurate than anything, but. And then you have all your expansion bays right there. This bottom one is really cool. Like I showed in the video, you just clip unclip. It's two clips on the side, bam, it comes right off. And you have your stuck on. There it goes. Oh, there's something in the way. This just slides right out. You have access to the underside of the case. And inside here, you just open it up. And it gives you access to all your stuff. So you get your additional screws, some extra mounting brackets. Like I said, all your screws, you came with a bunch of zip ties and your expansion slot grates or grills or whatever you want to call them. So yeah, this is it's a really nice, really neat feature. I like having access to everything right there in your case. Close that back up. And you just slide it right back in, like that. And you take the bottom cover, bam, snaps right in, and you're done. It's awesome. Okay, and then onto the back side of the case here. Like I said, you know, you got the bulge right there with the airflow. So when you do have the fans on the other side blowing across the hard drive cage, the air exits right out the side here because it's completely open. So it's really, but you don't feel the airflow. It's the fans aren't powerful enough that you really feel a breeze coming across there. So, let's see, what else can I say? Right up inside there, you can see it. I can't really see it. But you can see there's the radiator sitting under there. It's mounted from up underneath. You have the carrying handle. So, all right, guys. Well, this is just kind of a quick video to show everything up and running. And as you can see, the NVIDIA Surround is still up and going. Oh, there's my coffee. And the Myonix mouse. If you guys are really looking for a good mouse, this is I definitely highly recommend it. And my Logitech G110 keyboard. So, all right, guys. I guess that's it. Like I said, next will be probably some benchmarking and things like that. And yeah, just stay tuned and keep watching. Talk to you guys later.
This world will never be what I expected, and if I don't belong, who would have guessed it? I will not leave alone.